A very, very, very good afternoon, everyone. I'm Shubhangana Shukla, academic head for Shanti Juniors. Once again, we are here to have a session on hands-on learning experience, right? Like every time. Again, this time we are going to have an interesting session which would make our children learn a lot of things, and especially not to forget a way of learning science through fun way and interactive and innovative activity. So what is hands-on learning, right? Like agar hum generally bole, so what is hands-on learning? Like I already told you once, hands-on or experiential learning is nothing but using your body, your hands, your all five senses, and that is exactly what hands-on learning is, right? Why is it so important? See, if you remember, if you're working in an office, if you're a teacher, if you're a parent, if you're doing work at home, do you remember anything which you have just read and written and you can do it, perform it practically? No, that's just not possible. You need to do hands-on experiential learning about it, right? Like in simple way, I can say that learning by doing, okay? If we do something, we learn better. And that is why hands-on learning is very, very important part of preschool education. We at Shanti Juniors have always tried to bring in the concepts which help the children to learn better, right? So here today, I heartily welcome all the viewers who have joined us, and we will have a lovely session on interactive learning, basically on science, right? So there'll be small things, fun activity. The material list has already been shared on our pages, on our things which has been shared on emails and on Facebook. But in case you miss out on anything, don't worry. These are very simple materials. You can just see the video today. You can just see the live session today. And definitely you can do it later on. So it will bring in a sense of science in our children, using new words, using new vocabulary to all of them. But at the same time, they have a good, fun time, right? So for that, we have Mr. Kushal, who's already done activities with us earlier also. He is the actually the owner of Curio Box. He takes care of the learning and research department, and he's been in this business for more than 6 years now. They develop nice activities, small activities, but related to math science, which helps them to develop their sense of, learning, right? So I heartily welcome Mr. Kushal. He will be taking you through to the session. We'll be slowly and gradually showing you the materials, following them how to do it. And don't worry, you can always take a recap. You can post your questions. We'll be answering it. Okay. So all to you, Mr. Kushal, please take it over. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I welcome all the parents for this exciting session. And as ma'am said, your children learn by experimenting, and also when it is given in a form of a play, they learn it better. The conceptual understanding and the foundation becomes more stronger. And slowly, gradually, they also start researching on their own. And if you look at it, the materials that we are using, it's just very basic materials which are easily available at our home. So we are not even getting any customized material. So that's where it also develops a thought process in a child, that by using materials which is already there in the house, what are different things that we could create out of it. And when children, they create something on their own, there's like different emotions, different attachment that they have. And yeah, so that's what we're going to do today together. So a basic material, I'll just show you my table. So there are two things we're going to make today. One is we're going to make, an air rocket. And second, we're going to make a balancing joker. So there are new different words that kids will come across, like specific to air rocket as an activity. They'll understand air, they'll understand force, they'll understand what is air force, how real rockets get launched by applying the force at the base, and the rockets get launched. The same concept we are also going to use. Also, we are going to use a balancing joker. So that's where they'll understand equal weights, both the sides, balances things. So that's what we're going to do together. So I will just show you my table, that what all materials I have set it up. So if you it's very easy, quickly you'll be able to grab it up. So let me just show it to you. See, I have two pieces of cardboard, like two small pieces of cardboard that I have. Okay, I have a scale, a ruler, a two-side tape, some colors I have. I have these two clips, cloth clips basically. Then I have straw. One is fat straw and one is thin straw. So this one is going to be fat straw, and this is the thin straw. And if you see, the thin straw easily passes from the fat straw. So we will require a combination of fat straw and thin straw. Then we'll need a single side tape, a double side tape is there, some paper, white paper, just to show them what is Air Force, Caesar. This is all what we need. I'm sure pretty you'll be able to grab everything from your house and very quickly. Wonderful. So these are the materials that you need to create both the models. This materials is to create both of the things, air rocket as well as the balancing joker. We're going to use this material to create both the things. Wonderful.
Right. So yeah, just wanted to tell all the viewers. So now you can, now once sir has told you the materials, they're very, very simple materials. You just have to note them down. You can do this activity again and again, right? So again, you sir, once more, just show the material slowly and gradually to each one of them so that you can note down. In case you don't have the list, you can note it down for yourself.
Sure. Let's quickly go through it once again. So I've taken, cardboard pieces, basically, two pieces. So one we'll be using it to make the rocket, and second we're going to make it to make the joker, and a ruler that we would need, tapes, two side tape and single side tape, colors, cloth clips, two cloth clips, straw, one is the fat straw and second is the thin straw. And if you see, the thin straw easily passes from the fat straw like this, just freely moves. Okay. Then we need a scissor and some paper. That's it. This is what we would need for today's session. Wonderful. And when we use these basic materials, which are easily available at home, children get into a thought process of using the materials around them in a very productive way. It happens slowly, gradually, but that's where they become like an innovator, they become a problem solver by using basic things around us, how we can create something productive. And also what happens is when we get toys from outside, from the market, right, the child is definitely playing with it. But if we talk about, let's say, how the toy is working, or what is that inside the toy which is making the toy work, right? So a child never gets into that thought process. The child will definitely play with it, and play is definitely a very good sense of learning, I would say. But what we are doing today is a child is making and also trying to understand how it is working, what is the science or the logic or the concept behind the working of this toy. So it's like a complete package that a child will have, and a lot of new words that a child will come across. So not only making, but there's going to be an intellectual communication or discussion between the children. Okay, good. So let us start with our first activity, wherein we're going to try to understand force first of all, then we will try to understand air force. So in simple terms, our day never starts or ends by without using force. Force is something that we keep on using throughout the day. So force is nothing but it is a push or a pull. So let's say if I have this, a sketch pen packet on my head, if I push it or pull it, that means I'm applying some force. So if I pull it, this is force, but if I push it, this is also a force. It's very simple. So you can take any random object around you and then try to explain a child that push or a pull is force. Many times on the door, like office door and other places, we have always seen that push or a pull. So that push or a pull is nothing but it is force. So starting from the day, we actually wake up in the morning. So from the bed, we actually go down. So that's where we start using force. We will actually move here and there like that. We'll try to pull or push something, and then we will start our day. So starting from the day, we wake up in the morning, we start using force. Okay, force are of many different types, like unbalanced force, balanced force. So there are many different, which we are not going to discuss in detail, like what all different type of force are there. But specifically one force that we're going to understand today, which is air force. So I also request all the parents and all the viewers to also tell children to repeat these words. So ask them to say force, then ask them to say air force, right? So these are the words that they should try to say on their own. Now let us try to simply understand that what is air force. So for that, to explain it, what I'm going to do is I have this paper, which I'm going to, so if you look at it, just kind of moving right now because there is a fan which is trying to move. So the paper is moving because of the air force, okay? But we're going to use the force from our mouth. So that's where, we're going to cut small bits of paper. So if you look at it, I'm cutting small bits of paper. And this is going to be fun for children. So cut few, around 15-20 bits of paper, small bits of paper. And
here a disclaimer, sir, please parents and guardians and teachers guide them what kind of paper to be used. right? So you have to give them a separate piece of paper, or you can even guide them, you know, to use some paper, maybe newspaper, which is of no use as of now. Yes.
It's a regular paper that you can use, maybe a newspaper or any rough paper that you might have, any paper works. Okay, so I'm cutting just small bits of paper which I have gathered here, and I think this sounds to be good. Now what we will try to do is we'll just put it on one of our hand. Okay, and now we're going to try to blow the air out from our mouth. So what is going to happen is air is actually coming out from our mouth, so that air is going to actually strike on these bits of paper that we have, and the bits of paper will get some force due to which it will start moving. So let me just blow. See, this is an example of air force.
So this is the most fun loving activity which you can see, you know, the children hold, you know, they take sand in their hand, paper in their, anything. So, you know, parents and teachers, you can always keep using the word force when they are doing such activities in the school or at home. As of now, we are doing everything at home. So you keep using these, you know, vocabulary of science. So that would be the best way to introduce science to them.
So what we should do is we should, you know, to give them more insight of, you know, air force, we can take a few bits of paper and then ask them to hold, you know, put it on the hand and then ask them, see, you just ask them, see, the bits of paper are not moving right now, right? Are they moving? No. But the moment we take out some air from our mouth, the air from our mouth strikes this paper. So it gets a force of the air due to which the paper bit starts moving, right? You ask them, see, observe that it is not moving right now, right? Because there is no air force. But the moment you blow the air force starts coming out, it strikes the bits of paper and the bits of paper starts moving. See? So this is, you know, one of the easiest way and the fun way to explain child that what is air force. Okay, wonderful. So I'm sure all of you are trying, you know, to explain kids about air force. Let them also blow some air, okay? And then let them also try to feel that how, you know, air is coming out from our mouth and how the force of the air is making the bits of paper move.
And sir, recently, you know, whatever things happened in the weather itself, you know, there was a lot of force related to weather. So parents, teachers, even when you're talking about, you know, any kind of news related to weather, any information about weather, you can talk about air force, you know, force applied through air. So you try to relate things with the real world as well, right? Not right. Only for the mishappenings, also for good things. So whenever you're doing an activity, the child will be able to connect it directly with science.
Yes. Many trees were actually, due to recent, you know, cyclone that we had, many trees were actually, you know, they actually fall down, you know, from their roots. So many kids would have seen that. So that's an, you know, real life example that because of lot of air. So now when the air is moving fast, it is called as wind basically. So, and that's where we say that wind is, so it was the cyclone which we had was around 135 kilometer per hour, right? So that was a speed. So that was a wind basically. So whenever air is moving fast, it is called as wind. So due to that, you know, a lot of wind force or the air force, you can say, the trees were actually falling down. Okay. Good. Now we start with, you know, making the air rocket. So let's start the process. But before that, let us try to understand that the real rockets, if you look at it, real rockets, they get launched, you know, towards the space basically. But then there is a lot of force which gets, you know, generated at the base. Okay. The force which is created, you know, at the base of the rocket is letting the rocket move so fast. And it just, you know, goes out from the Earth's axis and then slowly goes towards the space. Okay. So there's a lot of force even, you know, the rockets are having due to which the rockets are launching. So it's kind of same thing that we're going to use. I mean, there is a different force. It is not definitely air force. It's like a different force which is created due to the fuel and due to the engine of the rocket. So here for us, again, we are also going to have an engine in our rocket, but our engine is going to be air-powered engine. So that's why, you know, we're going to use air from our mouth and the rocket will launch. Okay, so let's start. So first of all, we use one of the cardboard to make the air rocket, and we need to draw a design of a rocket, which I'll share it to you for your reference on the screen. You can make that design, or even you can make a simple design like this. This is kind of a simple design, you see. Okay, you can also make it like a simple design, or if you want to make it a little more creative, then I'm going to share it to you here on the screen. Ma'am, if you can enable me to screen share. Ma'am, if you can enable me to screen share, I'm not able to screen share.
Okay. I'll just try doing it. Yes, till then, parents and teachers, everybody, you can definitely, sir, I think now you can share the screen.
Okay.
I would always suggest whenever there is any kind of creativity required, please give them that scope of, using their own creativity, whether you're using their own colors or using their own, diagram, except for the outer part of, if it is a rocket, it has to be somewhere like rocket, but allow them to use their own imagination inside that, please.
In this activity, you can help them to create like a dotted lines, okay? And then let them connect the dotted lines and let them see how the rocket actually comes out with the help of dotted lines. So there are two designs. One is the design you are able to see it on the screen. And second, which I showed you here, you can also create like a simple design like this, okay? So any of the design would work better. The design which is there on the screen, you can also take a picture if you want to. It's completely fine. So take a picture and so this is like little big design and little complex, I would say. But this really looks nice as compared to this. So anyone, you can ask a kid to select, aapko ye banana hai ki ye wala banana hai, right? So let them, have their free choice and try to create the design that they want. Okay, so let us try to create a dotted lines on the cardboard. So I'm going to use a cardboard and I'm going to make a dotted line and let the child connect the dotted lines, and then you help them to cut the rocket. If they are not able to cut it, just help them to cut the rocket and then let them freely color on their own. So I am trying to create the rocket. I'm going to do the simple design. Okay, I'm not very good at drawing, so I'm going to use the simple design for now. All right. So I am trying to create a simple design. Let me just put the screen down so all of you could see. Okay. So here is the point where I'm starting and I'm trying to create a simple design like this. And then I'm gonna cover this part. Becomes like a simple design. And rockets generally have names. So you can also name your rocket like Apollo 1-5, or you can also keep it, let's say, your short name. Let's say if your name is, let's say Ved Thakkar, you can just write V and T. So you can, name your rocket as well. Okay. And then we will actually create like a window in the center. And then and then you can cut it and let the child color it out on their own and let them choose the colors that they want.
Sir, there's a request coming. Can you just stop sharing the screen, or I should all stop, because they're not able to see the drawing properly. Just stop sharing the screen so that my viewers can see them.
Okay.
Sir, I think now that's fine. Thank you so much. Yes.
So this is what I have done. I have made a very simple design, and in the center, like a window I have made. And now we will color it out. Generally, rockets are kind of white and grayish color. Why don't we make it so colorful? So let's try to make a colorful rocket. So I'm going to mix different colors, color it out, and make it a beautiful color. So all of you, all the kids, select the color that you like and start coloring it out. So I'm going
to
start.
It is clear to all the viewers. Sir showed first a diagram of a rocket, a very simple diagram of a rocket. Now that drawing, you have to make it on that piece of cardboard. And then you allow the children to color the way they want to, right? Just give them the scope of using their imagination and ask them to color that rocket. So there has just been the drawing part, and there is a coloring part which is going on. There's no cutting as of now.
Yes, after we color it, we will just simply cut it, okay?
Yes. And you will have to take care with children who are very small for using the, the scissors. So there's a disclaimer, please make sure that the elders are doing the cutting for very small children.
So coloring is going on, and you can also name your rocket. I'm going to name my rocket. I'm going to give some name. I'm going to write Shanti Junior Preschool. So I'm going to write S for Shanti, J for Juniors, and P for Preschool. SJP. Okay, SJP is my rocket name.
Right, absolutely fine. Yes.
Wonderful. So I'm going to do two colors. So it's like green and other color, two colors I'm going to combine. So our rockets are getting ready. And once the rocket is ready, we're going to take it to the launch pad to launch the rocket. Wonderful. So all right. Now I'm going to take another color. I will take orange. I'm going to mix two colors, green and orange. It looks like a flag of India, actually. Oh, this looks so beautiful. See, this combination of the color looks so beautiful. Green and orange, they're looking very nice. The saffron color and the green. Good. So I am done with coloring. So if you see, my colors are ready. I'm sure kids must be still doing it. So let them do it. We'll still give a couple of minutes for them to color it out. Good. My rocket name is SJP. And I will try to color a little bit in the center part as well. I'm going to make it little yellowish. So because it is window, it's like little transparent. So I'm going to do it little yellow color. So SJP will also be able to be seen properly. It's visible. And then this is the yellow color that I have in the window. Rockets have four stages. Generally, most of the rockets, they're like four compartments in the rocket. Okay. Each compartment is responsible for some work. Generally, the astronauts who travels in the space, they are always in the first compartment. Okay. And also the satellites. So generally, rockets are used to definitely travel in the space. Also, if you want to launch a satellite. Now, if you look at it, the internet or the cable TV, whatever things that we're getting, and then satellites are through satellites basically. And not only that, satellites are also responsible for many information that we keep on getting, around the Earth. So anything which is happening around the Earth, we keep on getting, this information using the satellites. Like all weather information, again, we get it using the satellites. So as I said, rockets have four compartments and each compartment is responsible for certain work. Most of the time, the lower three compartments are used to actually push the rocket out of the Earth's orbit, to put it in the space basically. So what they do, so there's exhaust basically, which is there when we start, and as and when rocket goes up, the fourth compartment gets separated, okay? And then again, the ignition of the third compartment starts, which will again apply some more force. Slowly, gradually, as and when it goes up, they try to reduce the weight of the rocket so that smoothly it can, go outside the Earth's orbit. And most of the rockets which we are using so far, they are not reusable. So once the rocket is used, it is not reusable. And that's where there's a lot of that's where rockets becomes very costly thing. And that is where a company who is based in USA, they are in talks a lot basically nowadays. The company is SpaceX, led by Elon Musk. They have developed reusable rockets. The rocket to use ho chuka, वो वापस उनको रीयूज कर पा रहे हैं. सो दैट्स एन अमेजिंग अचीवमेंट दैट दे हैव मेड. रिसेंटली दे ऑल्सो डिड कपल ऑफ फ्लाइट्स, टेस्ट फ्लाइट्स, एंड द रॉकेट वेंट अप एंड ऑल्सो केम डाउन. सो इट्स कंट्रोलेबल, बेसिकली कंप्लीटली कंट्रोलेबल. एंड सो दैट वॉज यू नो वेरी सक्सेसफुल थिंग दैट दे हैव बीन डूइंग. In India, we have a space organization, research organization, which is called as ISRO. They are the one who makes the rocket for India. They are the one who sends the rocket. One of the recently successful project that they did was the Mars mission, Mangalyaan. So they could send the rocket to the Mars, and then some other studies, research are going on. Same way, NASA, who is the space research organization for USA, actually sent a robot which is called as a rover, which is still there in Mars, and it is doing many different studies trying to find out if the life is possible on Mars or not. So you can also correlate how many planets are there, and now there is a rocket which was sent from Earth, now it is there on the Mars, and then trying to see that if the life could be possible on Mars.
Thank you so much for giving so much of information, because some kind of added information always brings some curiosity in our children also, so they may get interested towards learning more about it and maybe more active in learning what they are going to learn right now.
And trust me, such things are very fascinating for children at this age. It happens to very less number of children, I would say, but something that at this age if clicks their brain, then trust me, they become like one of the most amazing personality that I've seen many children. They, by looking at things, certain things, or by hearing a lot of such things, they become like that. I want to become like this, I'm going to do this. So there may be we as an educator, we always try to pass on such information that might inspire them, and that they might shine someday. Good. So now, after, if you have colored it out, so this is how my rocket looks like. Okay, I have done orange, green, and the window is yellow colored, and my rocket name is SJP. Now I'm going to cut it out. So we will just simply cut the borders, and we will get this part out. So let us start cutting the rocket, and let us try to get a shape of the rocket out. It's a very simple design that you're
Sir, this is for the viewers only. It's a very simple kind of cutting. So the children who can handle the child scissors can definitely use it. And only for the very, very small ones, you will have to help your children for cutting. Rest, I think it's very simple. If you give them round edge scissors, so bigger children more than 5 years of age can easily do it.
Wonderful. So yeah, it's very simple cutting. Basically, you just have to follow the line and cut it out. Okay, so I could cut out my rocket, and this is how it looks. Okay. Good. So our rocket design is ready, but now we're going to fix the engine. So I think I'm sure all of you would be cutting. So you can complete your cutting part, and then we will go to our next part to prepare the engine for our rocket, which will make the rocket launch. So the concepts here that we are learning is force, air force. That's what we've understood so far. We also understood that rockets have four compartments, and each compartment is responsible for some other work to send the rocket out of the Earth's orbit. Other than that, the space organization in India is called as ISRO. And the space organization in the USA, which is one of the most intelligent and powerful research organization, is NASA, which is based in USA. And then there is a company called as SpaceX, who created the rockets which are reusable, and which is led by Elon Musk. And they also created amazing electric cars, which I'm sure a lot of you would have come across with them, with name Tesla. So they are also going to come to India, with a lot of amazing electric cars.
Actually, you said that everything starts from a scratch. So now this is basically an introduction of science to our viewers and our little ones, right? Who can rightly start from yours? And when the moment they see bigger pictures, bigger videos, bigger news coming, on the television, they'll be able to relate what they have done. So basically, the concept is the same. The theories are the same. only thing that it becomes magnanimous when it becomes a bigger version of it, right? So if they know a smaller or small version of it, they'll be able to relate the concepts much better, sir.
Yes. Correct. Yes. So their vision becomes, you know, more broader basically. So we just try to introduce them to basic things, which is very important to make sure that foundation becomes very strong. Once the foundation is very strong, then they can, you know, keep building on it, and their vision becomes more clear and more broader slowly, gradually. Wonderful. So our rocket is ready, and now we're going to fix the engine. Okay. So now to fix the engine, here is where, you know, we're going to use both of the straws. So if you see, one is a fat straw and one is a thin straw. So if you see, thin straw easily passes through the fat straw. What we're going to do is we need to cut this fat straw, and the size that you would need, all of you may have a different size of your rocket. Some of you might have little smaller, some of you might have little bigger, but what we need to cut, the piece of the straw that we need to cut should be equal to the size of the rocket from the back side. So you can put this straw on the back side, and then try to measure it exactly like the size of the rocket. Okay, rocket ke size ki jitna hum log usko measure karenge, then we will cut it. So my rocket size is this much, so which I'm gonna cut it. I'm gonna cut a small piece of the straw which is equal to the size of the rocket. So now let me just quickly again check it out if this is equal or not. Yes, it seems it is equal. Yes, it is equal size. Okay, so here we are preparing engine for our rocket. Okay, and ma'am, just to talk to you about rocketry, like yesterday only we also created new designs of rocket. So they are like working models of rocket. Like yesterday only, you know, we actually introduced like rocketry 2.0, where they really make a real rocket basically. And then there is a rocket engine which we give it to them, and then once we apply a spark, then it just, you know, goes high. But then it is also a remote control that we have made. So yesterday only we actually launched the design of new rockets. Wonderful. So guys, this is how it looks like. Okay, the straw size equal to the size of the rocket, equal to the length of the rocket. And now we're going to fix this fat straw on the back side of the rocket that we have prepared. Okay, so to apply it, we will use a two-side tape. If you don't have a two-side tape, we can also apply single side tape by overlapping it over the straw and then sticking it up. Or you can use, two-side tape really works out well. So I'm going to take a small piece of two-side tape. So I'm taking a small piece of two-side tape, which I'll stick it here on the back side of the rocket, like this. Just press it well so that it sticks well. And after that, we're just going to, you know, peel the yellow part of the two-side tape. And then we're going to stick a small straw piece, which is equal to the size of the rocket. Just simply stick it. Whosoever doesn't have two-side tape, as I said, you can also overlap single-side tape two or three times here, here and here, and then you can stick it. So this is going to be the engine part of our rocket. This is how it looks, guys, so far. This is going to be the engine for our rocket. It is sticking well now. Good. So this is how my rocket looks like from the front, and this is how it looks like from the back side. Fat straw, we have applied a fat straw here. Okay, this is not the thin straw. And hope all of you are ready to launch the rocket. We are just done. Okay, and now one important thing. Whosoever have, let's say, bent straw. So the thin straw, generally they are bent. So if you have a bent straw, just cut the bent part. I have removed the bent part. I also had a bent part because we're going to use the straight part of the straw. Okay. Now, here is where, you know, something interesting that is going to happen, that we will try to launch the rocket and we'll see if it is launching or not. Okay. And some of the kids might feel that why the rocket is not launching, it's not going to launch, is what I am. Let me tell you, it's not going to launch. But so there's a question that, you know, I would like to put it in front of all the parents, and you can also ask this to the kids, or maybe all viewers who are there. Just try to push this thin straw inside the fat straw. Try to blow the air. Then you see rocket is not launching. ask them to put a hand here, and you will, and they will feel the air. And so what is happening? Air is just passing through. It is not creating any force, right? So here's the question. What change that we should make in our design that it creates the force of the air? Right now, air is just passing through. You can put down in the comments. कि क्या कर सकते हैं इसके लिए कि अभी एयर जो है वो सिंपली पास हो रहा है सी एंड यू कैन फील द एयर इफ यू पुट योर हैंड हियर एयर इज जस्ट पासिंग थ्रू सो व्हाट शैल वी डू टू क्रिएट द फोर्स ऑफ द एयर और टू ब्लॉक द एयर एयर को ब्लॉक करने के लिए हम क्या करेंगे आज इस क्वेश्चन टू अ चाइल्ड कि इसमें ऐसा क्या चेंज करेंगे व्हाट वी वुड लाइक टू चेंज हियर सो दैट द एयर डू नॉट जस्ट पास थ्रू It should create some force. So block hona zaruri hai, air ka block hona zaruri hai. So we need to block it somewhere. So I'm not sure if you guys have mentioned some answers. Ki kya kar sakte hai iske liye? But let me tell you what can we do. So I'm going to use a single sellotape, single side of tape, a small piece. I'm going to take it. This is what you know. I suggest you
just
might.
A small instruction for the parents and teachers and all the viewers. Please do not allow the children to cut their sellotape from their mouth. Please give them small scissors because see, he's a pro. He's been doing it on a daily basis, and we are in adults has been doing. So ideally, even we will not be doing it. So because it have germs in it, and it may go in the mouth of the child. So for the small children, you have to be very very careful. Just a small instruction for all of them.
Yeah, for sure. We should always, use a scissor. We've been kind of having, because we want to do,
I can understand, completely understand, because you've been doing so many things together. So that's absolutely fine. But because when we are, giving instructions to the children.
For sure. We should always
follow the right, certain things. Yes. Please, sir.
Good. So now this is a time wherein we are going to block the air which is passing through. Okay, so that's where I'm using a small piece of a tape that I have, and we need to block it here. So at the top, here is the top, the edge of the rocket. So here at the top, we will just apply tape and close this part. Simply put it, and then you try to press it and just apply the straw. Wonderful. So now you see this part is blocked now. Okay, this part is blocked completely. It is sealed now. And now let us try to see what happens when we try to blow the air. Okay, so again we're going to try to launch the rocket. So exactly like the real rockets launches, let us try to see if our rocket also launches. Here for us, this is our engine combined with this straw, and we're going to blow the air out from our mouth. So that's where we call it as air powered rocket. I'm putting this straw inside, the fed straw. And now let me try to blow the air. The more you blow hard, the more it goes high. 1, 2, 3, and it launches. So now what happened? So just ask a child that now what happened? Like initially, the air was just passing through it. Let me just quickly grab my rocket. Oh, wait, I have another one. Okay. So just now this time you ask them that you put your hand and you see, are you able to feel the air now? So they won't be able to feel the air now because it is getting blocked here. In the first case, they were able to feel the air because it was just passing through, right? But now second time, they will not be able to feel the air. And you see, when I'm just blowing it, the force, air force is getting applied over here and the rocket is launching. See?
Right. So the comparison between the two stages, the reason for not launching and then why it is launching, it's very, very important. So viewers, please, keep asking questions, because unless until you ask them questions, they will not be able to think about it and develop their problem solving skills also. So keep asking them questions and first try, let them try for an answer. If they're not able to give, then only you share the answer with them. Yes.
Right. We should just try to give them hints that isme straw lagaya hai. Straw lagaya hai, toh kya ho raha hai? Hawa toh simply how air is just passing through it. Toh isme aur kya? So just try to give them, some hints, I would say. And this definitely, as ma'am said, it develops, problem solving skills. Not only that, they also develop logical thinking behind it. all, if you look at it, a complete design thinking was already applied. So we have designed the rocket, we also designed the engine. So we are already into process of designing basically. So they're definitely developing design thinking, but on top of it, they are also developing scientific, understanding. Also, a lot of new words that they're coming across, and then they are developing problem solving skills. They're also developing the logical or reasoning skills. So whenever you are, it is hands on, a lot of things, skips into a bucket. And when child does 100 of such different experiment, the thought process of a child goes to a next level. Okay. So you should try with very small things, around it. Try to use very raw material. Do not try to use customized material. Okay. So there are a lot of things already there in our house. Like other sessions we did, like three other sessions that we did earlier, they've always used raw materials, right? This raw materials gives them a thought process to use basic things around them to use in a productive way and to solve a problem or to create something. Wonderful. Because if you look at it, the major problems in the society or a complex devices, they are actually made up of very small things. It is just their brain, the way they apply the brain, and then that's how things becomes complicated is what we feel, but they are not at all complicated. Even if you open, let's say, car engine, you might feel that it's so complicated, but they are really made up of very simple and basic things. So when they become very strong in their simple things, I'm sure it will become very easy for them to also create complex things. So this was our air rocket, guys. Okay, and we will
a small recap, because we have another activity also. Just quick recap of the of this activity, just very much in short, so that
they can... What we have done is we have created a design of a rocket like this. Then we colored the rocket, we named our rocket, and then we just have to simply cut it using the scissor, and this is how it looks like. And then on the back side, we have applied, we have stick the engine for the rocket, which is the fat straw, and the fat straw size is equal to the length of the rocket, which we have sticked it using a two side tape on the back side of the rocket. Okay, and then we are using the thin straw. So at the first time, we have not applied this tape here, so a child will feel the air coming out from the other side. So no force of air is created, but the moment we apply some tape, the air is no more coming out. It is not passing. The air will actually strike here, and the force of air would be created, and the rocket will launch. So exactly the same way, we just apply some force and the rocket launches. Good. So this is what we have done so far. Okay, we have made air powered rocket, and you can make a lot of such. Some interesting thing that you can try it out with your child. This is also a good exercise for your lungs, okay, because you're actually blowing the air out with a great intensity, and also to improve more on it. A very interesting game that you can create it out, and you can play with your child. You can create maybe 3 or 4 different rockets, according to the members that may be in your house. And then what you do, actually make a line like a little bit away from you, and then try to launch the rocket, and then try to compare kiska rocket wo line ko cross kar raha hai ya to kiska rocket sabse zyada dur travel kiya, right? So this is how an interesting game that you can play with them.
Right. So good activity. You can have comparative games like this. We can, it's not that only children can do it, we as adults would love to have such activities. And in fact, we are asked to do a lot of meditation and blowing activity and breathing activity. So what better way to do something like this, which is so much fun, and learn about science also. Right, sir. So now, sir, we can move on to the next activity.
Yeah. So now the next activity that we have is called as a balancing joker. Now, joker like a clown is a very fascinating thing for a child, because they actually make us laugh. And kids, due to their the type of the clothes that they wear, kids actually like it, right? Okay, so we're gonna try to create like a similar kind of a joker. And the joker initially would not be able to balance; it's gonna keep on falling down. And so we need to apply some science. We need to apply some mathematics, I would say, to make sure that the joker balances. So here the concept is about equal weights, that whenever you place equal weights both the sides, things balances, okay? Which you also seen in weighing scale. जब भी हम व्हेन वी गो टू परचेस सम वेजिटेबल्स एंड ऑल देयर आर वेट्स ऑन वन साइड एंड देन देयर आर फ्रूट्स और वेजिटेबल्स ऑन द अदर साइड व्हेन बोथ ऑफ देम बैलेंस इट्स लाइक इक्वल वेट ओके नॉट ओनली दैट इफ यू लुक एट अवर बॉडी लाइक लाइक अ रेगुलर पर्सन्स बॉडी अवर बॉडी इज ऑल्सो बैलेंस्ड राइट सो इफ यू लुक एट लेट्स से इफ आई स्टैंड अप एंड इफ यू सी माई बॉडी इज बैलेंस्ड Right now, if my body is probably not balanced, then there are chances where you know I might fall down. So let's say if I take one of my leg little bit up like this. Okay, so right now if you see, I'm trying to balance it. So it is right now it is not balanced. My body is not completely balanced. One of my leg is actually up right now. So there are I might not be able to stand like this for so long because it is not balanced, and I might fall down. Okay. So it is unequal weight right now, both the sides. So this is called, this is actually not a balanced body, I would say. And see now, I'm able to stand like this. We try to balance it like this, but you know, no more I'm able to balance now. So yeah, kids can also try this out just to show them what is balanced weight and what is unbalanced weight. Good. So we're going to use the similar, you know, thing of balance weight and unbalanced weight, and when we're going to try to balance the joker. Okay. Now we're going to use another piece of cardboard to design the joker, and this design needs to be a little precise. Okay. And I'm going to share with the design that how it should look like. And I have made sample also. If you want to quickly see, this is how it looks. Yeah. This is like upside down. Okay. So this is how it looks. Like a little funny, and yeah, and then if you see, I've also decorated like a dress of a joker by making dots. So we're gonna make a similar type of a joker on another cardboard. For that, we will use a scale to make some lines, and again we will color it out, cut it out, and then we will see it is not getting balanced, and then by putting some other weight, it will get balanced. Another example, if I give it to you. We many times we might have seen a girl walking on the rope on a roadside. Okay, so if you might have observed that girl carry a long heavy stick, okay, due to which she is able to stay on the rope. If there is no weight, then she will probably fall down. And also the stick is equally divided, so there's equal weight both the sides, which is making her balance. Okay. Not only that, whenever we actually right now when they are learning cycling, they have like side wheels, so due to which they actually do not fall down, right? But slowly, gradually, when they practice, they actually remove the side wheels, and then after they learn balancing. So this is how, you know, this is another example that you can give it to them, that both the side wheels which are there on both the sides, it is helping them to balance. If there is side wheel only on one side, and if it is not on the other side, then there are chances when they might fall down towards the side where there is no side wheel. Okay, so some example like that, you know, you can try to give them. So it needs to have equal support or equal weights both the sides to balance things. Wonderful. Now we're going to create a design of a joker. I'm going to share my screen, which will help you to create the design of the joker. Here is the design of a joker. Okay, which we'll try to create. You can again create a dotted lines and let them connect it, or you can draw it completely and give it to them. This is like little complex for them to design. So you can definitely help them to create this design of a joker. So I'm going to start designing now. Same is the design I'm going to make, and no other alternative for this design, because this needs to be precise. Considering the balancing thing, it needs to be very precise. So I'm going to use this cardboard to draw it out. Okay. So I'm going to start. You can observe the way I'm doing it. I'm also looking at the design, and I'm going to try to make it. So I'm going to draw the first line like this. I'm going to start from hand. Okay. And then I'm going to draw it up like this. Okay. Good. So this is one of the hand, and then I'm going to design the head part, which is like this, a little triangle. Good. So this is done. And now here from hand, it is like a straight design that we have, like a straight, tummy part, I would say, that is straight. And then again, there are legs.
Sir, I think everybody has seen the diagram. So then you can stop sharing. I hope in case, yeah, so that, you know, they know how the drawing has to be done. So they can follow your drawing also.
All right. Okay. Thank you, sir. So, yeah. So I'm now creating a second hand. Okay, and okay, this is the second hand that we are creating. Okay, and now the straight line that I'm gonna make for the tummy part. Okay, and then we'll try to create the legs. Okay. All right, so this is how my Joker looks like.
I think I hope everybody has got it. One, the top part is more like a W, and then with the legs we can have as a reverse V, or in, you know, a kind of an A. It's a very, yep, very simple drawing which you can do. It's very simple, only made of using straight lines only. So now I think, sir, we need to cut it out, or after the coloring, right?
Yeah, we will color it out with, you know, bright colors. So I'm gonna use red color, blue, and a fluorescent color. And we will make dots. So we're gonna just make the dress of the Joker. Okay. Okay, and also we can, we have to make eyes of the Joker. Okay, so here is where, you know, I'm gonna create the eyes. Okay, and kind of a nose, little nose for the Joker. And this is the cap part, which will just, you know, kind of color it out with the red color. Good, and we'll try to make the dress more beautiful by putting more colors. Put more, little bit of blue color. All right, my design looks good to me. I'll just increase the size of the eyes. I'm gonna keep like a smiley face. Good, this is how it looks, guys. See?
So again, I'm quoting here, you can ask your children to be creative, make it them, you know, as funny as possible, because the children should be able to see a happy face and a funny face when they are drawing a Joker. So please allow them to use their creativity in using colors and, you know, designs in the Joker.
But after we color it, after we apply the dots and all, then simply we can cut the Joker from the lines in the outside. So we can start the cutting part after the coloring is done. You can help kids to cut. This is like little complex cutting, and it has to be precise. Just make sure by mistake they don't cut the hand or the leg. Otherwise, you'll have to create the Joker again. All right.
Emma?
Okay, so here is where I am, you know, cutting cutting my joker. So now I'm cutting the hand part. Okay, so all right, now I'm just cutting the space between the legs that I have. Okay, so this is how it looks, guys. See, I could cut this such a cute joker.
So I think this is a very simple diagram to prepare and not very difficult to even cut because it has more of a straight line cutting. So you can easily cut this joker out.
Yep. Okay. So my joker is ready. I hope all of your joker is also ready. And you can also color it on the backside if you want to, maybe later on. Just to make it, you know, more decorative, you can also make colors on the backside if you want to. So this is how the joker looks like. Okay, and we're gonna try to hold it. We're gonna try to now the exciting part, you know, begins now. So we're gonna try to so the joker will remain upside down, and now from the head part we're gonna try to put it on the finger and try to balance it. So ask a child that, put it on your finger and see, are you able to balance it? So now it's kind of falling down, see? See, so just give example of that simple girl, which I was talking about on the roadside, that you see, that is trying to, so probably if she is walking on the rope without the stick, then she will probably fall down. Same is the case with Joker. Joker is kind of, you know, falling down because there is no weight given to Joker. So now here we're going to ask them that what could we do to apply the weight. Okay, you can use many different things, not only the cloth clip, but you can also put clay basically, or maybe toffees, anything that you can place, little heavy in size. And now we say, I'm going to simply place this clip here on the one side. Okay, and then let us check it out that what is happening now. Weight is more this side. Okay, now put the joker on the finger. Now see, it's not falling down, but the weight is more this side. So it's kind of tilting on one side. Now let us also place the clip on the other side. And now let's see what happens. Now the joker balances, it does not fall down, see? It completely balances because of equal weights both the sides. Balances the joker, see? Even if you move like this, it does not fall down. In fact, it starts moving left, right, see? Even if you kind of, you know, stand up and rotate all around, it will also rotate, it will not fall down. It's like a perfect balancing. Now, interesting thing here is every time you change the position of the clip, you will see some change, you know, of balancing in the joker. So if I take this clip a little bit outside, now ask a child, agar hum isko bahar rakhenge aise, to kaun se side would tilt hoga, which side will it tilt? Okay, now if you look at it, the clip is kind of, you know, outer, and one clip is as it is, so it will actually tilt on the side which is tilt, see? Okay, because weight is going towards outer side. Right, now the same clip, if you keep it a little bit in like this, then if you see from the center, the weight is more towards this side. This is actually called a center of mass. If you take it a little bit in detail, it is, you know, center of mass. which, you know, we are not talking to a child right now. It becomes a little tricky for them to understand, but they should understand equal weights are required to balance things. See, now it is tilting this side because the weight is more this side. Okay, so the center of mass got changed basically. Wonderful.
So here, actually, there are two things, sir, which is, you know, the children are learning today is one, the major concept of balancing. Second is about equal distribution of weight that would help in balancing any object, right? So even if the direction of the weight is in an other side, the movement of the body or the movement of the object would be on the other side. So the child should be able to understand that balancing only happens. All those who have seen the mothers going to the vegetable market and, you know, have seen those weighing scales, they would actually understand the equal weight helps in balancing the object. So that is a very good concept. And obviously, we are doing it in a very fun way. So they'll always be having a lot of fun that I'm trying going to balance in a joker. So you can also come up with your own innovative ideas and come up with something new which is available at home. But at the same time, keep using the vocabulary of science so that they get into the understanding of concepts which may go in a higher level later on. Yes, sir.
Not only that, you can try to place this, you know, joker on different places. Yeah, so let's say, this is like more funny, we're going to try it out. Then let us try to balance this joker on our nose like this and see if you're able to balance it. See, put it on your nose and try to balance it. See,
yes.
Wow, this is like a perfect balance. Okay, you can try to put it on your ears. Let's see if you're able to balance it. Kids who have specs can also try to balance it on your specs. Okay. So I don't have specs, but I'm going to try to balance it on my ear. Try different body parts. Try to balance it over here on your mini finger. See? Try to balance it here on your elbow. My elbow is a little bigger, so I won't be able to do it, but you can try it out. Okay.
Yes, sir. Children have very thin hands, so they can definitely balance it on their wrist or. So it's very, very easy activity, but it develops a good sense of balance and with equal weights. So you can do small experiments with that, keeping obviously their safety in mind.
Now, if you put it, let's say, on a pencil or a sketch pen like that, and then when you blow the air, and air should actually see here again the force of the air, the correlation of the first activity, it's going to spin like a merry-go-round seat. More, if you apply like force which is not consistent, it might fall down. And this should be consistent force, and then it will keep on spinning.
So here they are learning about balancing and at the same time using of air force, right?
Yes. Good. Any questions that are there in the comments, we can try to answer it out.
Thank you so much, sir. I think you've already given them a lot of information about science and, you know, using different vocabulary, how does it work, starting even the fun activity of explanation of the rocket itself was a good information for all of us. So thank you so much, sir, for joining us today. And to all my viewers, please make sure that science is not about big gadgets, only metal objects and ready to use kits. It always comes from a scratch. It always comes from home and small items, right? So we have brought this activity only to make the children also realize, you know, they can learn good vocabulary, good knowledge about science using whatever is available at home, but simple experiments, right? So keep doing such experiments at home and keep watching us every time we come online. And it's real good fun. It's good experience to have you all viewers, so that we also give good learning to all our little juniors and all those who are watching us. Thank you once again, all of you, for joining us. And thanks from all the fraternity of Shanti Juniors for having a good weekend. Thank you so much. And please do take care of yourself. Thank you so much.